Hey guys, welcome to the Health Samurai channel. I'm Mike Levshin, health IT geek and member of FHIR community. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to use SQL with FHIR data. With the emerging FHIR standard, we are going to have tons of health data in FHIR format in the near future. Just look at big vendors. HealthKit from Apple, Google, Cerner, Epic, they all work on FHIR interfaces. So we are going to have huge data sets and we can use them to get new knowledge from it. But which tool we are going to pick to use that job? SQL. SQL is a perfect fit for data analysis because it's industry standard, everybody knows it, it's been there for decades. But can it be used to work with FHIR data? Let's find out. In this video, you will see how to install Fhirbase, an open source product by Health Samurai, which provides you an easy way to import FHIR data from various sources into the PostgreSQL database. And PostgreSQL database is the world's most advanced open source relational database. It has a set of really unique features among other open source relational databases. But most importantly for our case, it supports JSON format and Fhirbase uses that feature heavily. So let's go back to the Fhirbase site. Fhirbase site is healthsamurai.io/Fhirbase. There is a link in the description of the video and there is a get started button right there, which will point us to getting started tutorial. And what we actually going to do now is to perform a step-by-step walkthrough and we will see how to install everything and how to use Fhirbase. And our first step is to install PostgreSQL. I am on macOS, so I will follow macOS section here, but there are sections for Windows and Linux as well. And I prefer to use postgres.app installer. Let's go to their site and I'll just click the download button here. Installer is a regular DMG image. Once DMG file is downloaded, click on it. And just drag that icon to the applications folder. Now open applications folder in the Finder, double click postgres.app, and you see that Postgres is running. It has created a couple of databases for us. Just close it, close that window. You can notice that there is a small elephant icon in the notifications area and you can always open Postgres, open that window again. But we need to perform one more step to finish our installation. So we performed those two steps and the third step here is to copy that command line, then open the terminal application and just paste it here. It will ask you for your password provided. And then just close terminal application and open it again. Then you will be able to type psql command. It's a command line client for the Postgres. Just type psql, press enter, and you will get the Postgres prompt. You can invoke some trivial statement here just to check that everything is working. Then press /q to quit the psql. You have PostgreSQL running on your macOS system. Now let's proceed to the Fhirbase installation. Let's go back to the Fhirbase site and click the download button.
Pick right distribution for your operating system and architecture. I will pick this one. Once binary was downloaded, go back to the tutorial and find that command to make downloaded binary executable, copy it, go to terminal application, paste it and replace that path with the path where you actually downloaded the binary. The next step is to rename Fhirbase-operating-system-architecture to just Fhirbase. Use mv command for that. And the final step is to put Fhirbase binary somewhere in your path variable. You can skip this step if you don't know what the path variable is, but in that case you will have to type full path to the binary every time you invoke every Fhirbase command. So instead of just typing Fhirbase, you will type tilde downloads Fhirbase in my case. In your case, it will be a different path. I know that /usr/local/bin is inside my path variable, so I will just move Fhirbase binary there. And now I can type just Fhirbase and I see the help text, and that's it. We have Fhirbase installed. The next step is to create a database where we are going to store our Fhir data. We will use a psql client to do this. Type psql and then use create database statement to create a new database. Provide some name for the new database. I will call it Fhirbase. Don't forget to put semicolon at the end of the statement. Press enter. And if you got create database text of the response, then database was successfully created. Type /q and press enter to quit psql. Now when we have a newly created database, we have to initialize it with schema where we are going to store our Fhir resources. We will use a Fhirbase init command for that. Type Fhirbase. Then provide a Fhir argument which specifies a Fhir version we are going to use. 3.3.0 and provide a database name, Fhirbase in our case, and name of the command you need. Press enter. So our database was successfully initialized with Fhir schema. Okay, now we have a newly created database with Fhir schema in it and we are ready to import Fhir data into that database. There are several possible sources of Fhir data for Fhirbase. Local files like standard Fhir bundles, ng.json files, and also bulk API endpoint on the remote server. Now we will use an ng.json file we are using for Fhirbase demo. It contains Cynthia data in it, and we will download it from Fhirbase GitHub repo. So go to Fhirbase site and press GitHub link here. Navigate to demo folder and click on bundle.ndjson.jzip file. Then press the download button here. Once file was downloaded, switch back to the terminal. And let's type a Fhirbase command to load that file. As in previous comment, we will provide a Fhir version. We will use a database name. The name of the command is load. And we need to specify a path for the downloaded bundle. And that's it. Now you see how Fhir resources are being imported into the database. Fhirbase supports two insertion modes. First one uses insert statements and second uses copy statements. Copy mode is faster than insert mode, but only when inserts bundle your resources are grouped by resource type. So if you have huge chunk of resources of the same type in your source bundle or source bundles, because Fhirbase allows you to import several bundles at once, then use copy mode and use insert mode otherwise. You can find more detailed explanation of import modes in Fhirbase documentation. So the import process is finished and Fhirbase displayed some statistic information about resource types and how much resources we imported. And we can use the SQL client again to check if resources are actually in our database. We will switch to Fhirbase and we will invoke a count query on a patient table to see how much patients we have. It's 600. Yeah, same as here. Let's check how much observations we have. Yeah, same number as there. So our FHIR resources was successfully imported in the database, what is really cool, and we are ready to perform some SQL queries on them. Let's, for example, calculate an average age of patients in our database. We will start with select statement, then aggregate function average, then we need to extract year component from age between now and resource. Here I will provide a path inside JSON document to get a birth date. From patient. Yeah, because we need to provide a typecast for that statement here. So we need to cast string containing date to date data type. Let's take next example from Fhirbase tutorial. So let's go to the Fhirbase homepage once again. Click a Get Started tutorial and scroll down to that final query. So we are going to query given names, group by them, and we will order them in descending order, so we will see most popular name at the top of the results table. Let's copy it, switch back to terminal, paste it, press enter, and we see that Andrea 7 is most popular name among our dataset. It's because we use Cynthia to generate the dataset, and Cynthia appends digits after given names just to make them more unique. So that's it. We successfully installed Fhirbase and PostgreSQL. Then we prepared our database, imported some data in it, and performed a query. Perfect.
So guys, as you saw, it's definitely possible to use SQL on FHIR data. If you liked that video, press like button, leave us a comment. If you got some troubles or questions, we will answer them on next videos. And stay tuned.